Hey everybody, BrickLover18 here today to review set number 60092, the Deep Sea Submarine. This set is ages 6 to 12 and has 274 pieces. Subscribe to BrickLover18 for more daily LEGO videos. This set does come with three LEGO minifigures, a LEGO shark, this little underwater island thing, as well as the submarine. Now let's take a look at the minifigures that come in this set. So here's the first minifigure, and he is the submarine driver. As you can see, he's got this really cool, like, red and dark red torso, and it looks really neat. It looks like a hoodie with, you know, a walkie-talkie, and I just like the multiple different prints and colors on this torso. It just adds a lot. His beanie there actually does match the color of his sleeves and, like, the little bit of a shirt, which is very neat. And he does have back printing. As you can see, it's got, like, the logo of, like, maybe his trucking or his submarine company or something like that. The next minifigure here is a female diver. Before we really get started in showing her off, as you can see, she does come with a camera, some flippers, as well as this back oxygen tank. Her diving suit's pretty cool, and as you can see, there's torso printing as well as leg printing. It carries it on, so it gives it the more wetsuit effect. This minifigure also has back printing, but you can't really see that because of their oxygen tank. This third minifigure is pretty much the exact same as the second figure, but as you can see, it's got a different head, and it doesn't have a camera accessory. As I mentioned, this does come with this really cool shark. As you can see, it's one of the newer style, smaller sharks. The older style, you could fit a full minifigure in it, like, you could eat it. Unfortunately, in this one, you can't eat any minifigures. Sorry, A-Fall Man. Still a pretty cool looking shark, though. The first part of the set that I'm going to talk about is the underwater, you know, grotto sort of thing. As you can see, the whole part of the set here is on this, like, dark tan base plate. I think it's to represent, like, wet sand. Well, you know, that makes sense to me. There's this little crab down here, you know, just swimming around, as well as some different leaves and seaweed pieces just to give it, you know, because it is an underground look. We'll talk about this white thing here in a minute, but as you can see at the back here is this big, you know, tall underwater rock. It looks pretty neat from the front, but it is just a burp, a big, like, ugly rock piece, so there's nothing very special about it at the back. You probably noticed by now this big white thing, and you're wondering what that is. What it actually does is it lifts up, and it reveals this really awesome treasure chest underneath. When you open up the treasure chest, as you can see, there's lots of different gold coins, as well as some rubies and some gems. The treasure chest does just sit on these plates, so it's easy to take off when, like, the minifigures go diving, and they can pick up the chest and bring it back up to surface. This submarine looks sick. So as you can see on the bottom here, there's these, like, really big tubes, and I think they're used, I don't even know what they're used for, so I'm not gonna lie and make it up, but there are these really big tubes, and as you can see, they have some stickers on them, so maybe they're gas. That actually kind of looks like gas with the danger logo, and it's neat because they've got these, like, guardrails on it, so my whole theory about gas is actually starting to make a bit more sense now. As you can see on the front of these, I guess these are lights or something like that, so maybe they're gas-powered lights, I don't know. At the front here, they do have these two little arms. As you can see, they're quite movable. You can, you know, turn them all around, all different directions, and it's very cool. On this side, it's got various tools and, you know, satellite dish pieces, not sure what they're being used for. And on this side, it's got more of a mechanical arm, so it could, like, grab the treasure chest and things like that. Up at the very front here is the cockpit. So what you do is, you know, you just push it all the way down. It's this big, like, ball piece. And you can sit your little conductor minifigure on the inside here, put the little glass up, and there you have it. Also on the inside here is this little sticker piece that gives, like, you know, the fuel range and whatever that 89% means. And on the other side here is just, like, a sonar radar of the ocean floor. Here on the side of the submarine, it uses these really cool mudguard pieces to allow the arms, and I just think it adds a little lot more detail. It, like, allows the arms to move, and that's the same on both sides. And besides that, there's this little save. This side is empty, and so is this side, apparently. At the top here, more just random sticker pieces are being used. The EO one with the logo again, with more caution, but maybe they're more gas things or something like that. And then there's these little two antennas up here on the front, as well as this more light, I'm gonna guess, it's a light panel. At the back of the submarine here, it does use a lot more detail with the hose pieces, the hose pieces on both sides, as well as these two propellers. So these propellers obviously, you know, glide it through the water, which is kind of neat. And at the back here, there's these two little fin or tail pieces with the logo again on it. Very cool. Nothing special about the back of the submarine here. You can see these two little jets some more, and then some detailing back here, but that's pretty much it. Again, nothing very special. So this is a pretty awesome set. The submarine here does have some unique play features where you can move the arms and open up the minifigure hatch and just some other things like that. Overall, I really love the way this looks. I think there's a lot of great design features to just add a lot to the submarine. It's hard to kind of show them all on video because it just kind of the way you look. Do you like it? Like, that obviously looks really cool to me, but everybody might be a little different. Overall, I think it's a really neat looking submarine with some neat play features. I love this big glass dome, by the way. Like, that's great. Thanks everybody so much for watching a set review of set number 60092, the Deep Sea Submarine. This is a really neat set and definitely one of my favorites in the LEGO City Submarine line. I have some more LEGO City underwater sets, so stay tuned because I plan on doing videos on those as well. Thanks everybody again for watching and have a great day.